like working with machines, problem solving, working with your hands? Then this next career might be for you. Let's meet a machine operator. Hi, I'm Brian.
Hi, Brian, I'm Peter. You want to take a walk around my shop?
Sure.
Let's go. My name is Peter Tootens, machine operator, Penticton, BC. A machine operator is a person who operates a piece of equipment to take a raw product and create a finished product. And in my end, it's taking raw steel plate and cutting profiles out of it. I use a plasma cutter, which is a high intensity flame, to pierce and cut the plate into profile shapes. I will produce different material thicknesses to go to brake press, performing, or machine shop for machining, or to the fabricators and welders down the line. And from there, it goes, of course, to sandblasting and painting, and then we have people that assemble all this stuff, too.
You're getting the product brought into Hue, and you're cutting it all apart, yep. And that is the key part, is precision.
Yes, they know that they've got 20 parts. All 20 parts are going to be exactly the same. They don't have to adjust their machine or adjust their setup. I start my day, come in, just get the coveralls on, get the work boots on, put the safety glasses on. I go turn my machine on because it's a computer, so it needs to boot up. Turn on my gases that I'm going to use for it. Look at my programs, my sheets that I'll be cutting, and load material on that's appropriate for the size, the thickness that I need, and the size of the plate. Then I will set up the machine to cut that program. So I got to put in parameters and adjust things. There's a lot of input into it. And then watching the machine, listening to it, cut quality has got to be number one. It's mentally, I'm always having to be on cue, sort of thinking what I'm doing now and what I'm going to be doing later, and even into days ahead, because I have to order my material that I'm going to be cutting for jobs that I won't even be starting till next week. I got to order material now.
A lot of people would think that this job, because you're operating a machine, that the machine's doing all the work, but you're also doing a lot of heavy lifting.
Yes, as each piece gets cut, I have to pull it out, and it requires that you handle it, and you carry it, you pick it up, you have to put it over to where a person will clean it, and it is heavy, yes. Yeah. You want to make sure you double check everything before you start cutting, because if you have the wrong material, you're wasting time, but also you're wasting the cost of that material. My typical day starts at 7 o'clock and ends at 3:30. When it's busy, there's overtime, and it can be an hour or two on a typical day, or sometimes coming in on a Saturday and even working a whole shift. What attracted me to this field of work? For me, it was the satisfaction of creating a finished product.
So with everything that you do, would you consider yourself a craftsman?
Yes, with my machine, do my work with, I take pride in my work, it cuts a beautiful product, I would definitely consider myself a craftsman. The training for my position would be, you need grade 12, you need good math skills. For training, 1.5 to 2 weeks on job training of watching what I'm doing for 3 or 4 days, then you start to push buttons and start to get a little bit more hands-on, and then basically the last 3 or 4 days, I'll be off as a helper, and letting you work doing the job and just giving little pointers on it. The computer end of it has improved it and sped it up. Using a plasma cutter compared to using a torch cutting has increased the production. So your speed that you're working at, the material that you're cutting, is 5 times what it was before. When you can have pride in your work, it makes work enjoyable because you can see what you're doing contributes something to a finished product that goes off to a customer.
Peter, thank you so much for taking your time today.
No problem. Have a great day.
You too. Once again, I'm Brian for CareerTrek, reminding you that this career could be yours.